في هذه الأمسية سنقوم بتكريم أحد كبار السينمائيين وكتاب السيناريو الأمريكيين في الوقت الحالي، وبدون شك أكثرهم انتماءً لأوروبا، جيمس غراي. جيمس غراي هو في نفس الوقت الوريث الرائع للنهج الكلاسيكي المستلهم من كبار المخرجين الأوروبيين في خمسينيات وستينيات القرن الماضي، أمثال فيدريكو فيليني، لوكينو فيسكونتي، فيتوريو دي سيكا. إذن هو ينتمي إلى هوليوود الجديدة في السبعينات، كذلك لفرانسيس فورد، كوبولا أو مايكل كيمينو. جيمس غراي اكتشف في سن 25 من خلال فيلم أوديسي الصغيرة، وهو أول أفلامه، وقد فاز عنه سنة 1994 بجائزة النقد في مهرجان دوفيل وجائزة الأسد الفضي بمهرجان البندقية. تنتمي أعمال جيمس غراي لكل الأزمنة، وهي شخصية لأبعد الحدود، وتهتم بمشاكل الأبناء، بالمآزق الأخلاقية، وبالأخص هشاشة الأشخاص الداخلية، ولهذا تتسم أفلامه الثمانية بنقاء سردي لا مثيل له. وليومنا هذا قد يطغى على إبداعاته الأسى، إحساس حزن من تعرض لخيبة الأمل، كل ذلك في انسجام من الميلودراما الوجودية في حلة كلاسيكية، في أفلام الجريمة، في الأوديسي الصغيرة، فيلم الساحات، ونحن نملك الليل وحلة رومانسية في فيلم عاشقان إلى أعمال أخرى تخص حقبة زمنية معينة من خلال فيلم المهاجر، المدينة المفقودة زي، والمغامرات في فيلم الخيال العلمي في فيلم إلى النجوم. James Gray's stories are seldom separate from his native city, New York, where his 8 feature movies take place. His main characters desperately struggle in a city that often challenges their dream of a better life. And his movies seem to always carry on main idea. No matter how hard you try, you can't escape your origins. James Gray has built a body of work which is as universal as it is personal, yet quite complex. The Immigrant perfectly illustrates that. In the movie, we explore the reality of Polish immigration to America at the beginning of the last century, and we watch how such great dreams are lost to the absurd condition of the lived experience. The Immigrant is made dazzling by Marion Cotillard and by the beautiful direction of James Gray. James Gray wrote his movie with Lillian Gish in Griffith's Mute in mind. And I quote him saying, "Her incredible face reminded me of René Falconetti in Dreyer's The Passion of Jeanne d'Arc." Ladies and gentlemen, to present this award to James Gray, we are very happy to welcome tonight Marion Cotillard.
Good evening. I'm here tonight to honor my friend and cherished collaborator, James Gray, with the Marrakesh International Film Festival's tribute. James Gray is one of those artists for whom it is vital to create and share their art. Each of his films reflects a piece of himself. They explore his own soul and offer us his inner journey so that we can too question ourselves about ours. His earliest works, films like Little Odessa, The Yards, and We Own the Night, were in fact actively built around specific details from his and his family's life. But as James has said, autobiographical is not the same thing as personal. James puts his life into his work. He offers his intimacy, his sensitivity, his vulnerability, his strength, his humor. This is the reason why his art is so vibrant and will always reach the truth. What could be more generous than sharing one's tumult, never without indecency, in a deep, fiery, and vital artistic gesture? With two lovers, he explored hard-bitten romance in a Russian-Jewish neighborhood. With the Immigrant, he crafted a lush fable that resonated with his ancestors' journey. With the Lost City of Zed, he expanded into more complex themes of class hierarchy. That word was a problem for me. Hierarchy, something like that. Hierarchy, quoi. Voilà. With Ad Astra, he explored the intimacies of father-son relationship on an epic sci-fi canvas. Now, with Armageddon Time, James has bridged these two pursuits, the autobiographical and the personal. Every time he makes a film, it seems there is someone there to call it his most personal yet, but it's truly never been more applicable. The precision of his eye, the obsessive details he wrote into the screenplay, He has said he wanted to shoot his childhood memories as if this was a ghost story. It truly does feel like a film haunted by its maker, or perhaps it's the other way around. Yet, Armageddon Time does not merely reflect and repurpose certain aspects of James' youth for a dramatic narrative. It centers them in such a way as to cast light on the enduring issues of our time and the inequities facing the world today. I was lucky enough to get to be part of one of James Gray's great adventures with The Immigrant. It was not an easy production, one with little money for big dreams, but oh, was it a profound, unique, and beautiful experience. I saw James smile, I saw James suffer, I saw James fight for what was important to him, which was telling his story. He managed that trick of finding the universal in the personal and transcending his own story to tell a larger one. All of these ideas are refined with his wonderfully classicist approach to filmmaking. He is a master of striped down and simplistic stories that resonate deeply because they concern themselves with eternal truth. They're assembled with craft that never gets in the way, but is at once beautifully wrought. Whatever the period, they're timeless. James is an artist. Not least of all because you're sure to find his DNA in every single frame, whether he takes you into orbit around Neptune or seats you in a lively family dinner table, he always manages to find that which is real, honest, authentic, and so familiar. It is my absolute pleasure to present this tribute to James Gray.
Thank you, Marion Cotillard. Before proceeding, let's now watch some sequences from the films that together make up James Gray's career.
I just wanted to tell you guys, if something goes wrong, you don't panic. You tell me. Or if you can't, you just go on as planned. You forget about it.
I just want to say that I am very happy to have you all here. And the last few years have been, well, sometimes not so easy, but that's all over now.
You know, you've been causing me a lot of difficulty. The police have been coming to see me.
I need you to help me.
What is it you think I could do?
I thought maybe you could talk to some of them people, you know, because I didn't kill anybody.
Do you have any idea who did?
Hey, Mr. Green, thanks for hooking me up, man.
Hi.
Hey, Bobby.
Hey,
we got the best club in Brooklyn, man.
Just wait till I take over Manhattan, baby.
What are you doing? You don't say hello?
I didn't even see you. How you doing?
Good.
Cool.
Are you going in the city?
Yeah.
Oh, great. You can keep me company.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, you ever count doors?
What?
1, 2, 3, 4. You're trying to guess which door you're going to. 8, 9, 10. I'll give you a hint. Under 20. 11.
12.
13.
Look at that. No, it's a good number.
Yes.
My last confession was a long time ago. I have many, many sins. I tried to steal money. They say I am a woman of low morals. And this man comes. He promises to help me.
You are so beautiful.
I let him use me. And I stay with him. And I'm ashamed.
So much of life is a mystery, my boy. We know so little of this world. But you and I have made a journey that other men cannot even imagine. This has given understanding to our hearts.